Hello friends, this is Jalpesh here and welcome again to my channel Code with Jerry, and welcome again to the new video. So this will be a part 2 of the previous video, which will be CRUD operations with ASP.NET Core MVC, Entity Core, Entity Framework Core and SQL Server. So we have performed CRUD operations with all these technologies. In the previous video, like, there are so many things to cover. So there are some points which I wanted to cover in detail, so I thought like it would be great to have a part 2 of this particular video where I can explain things in the details. But before moving to that, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe to my channel, because if you see my views in the channel, like 80% of views are without subscription, and if you subscribe to my channel, then it gives me more motivation to create more videos like this. So please, I am putting lots of hard work to create this kind of video, then so please do subscribe. Let's move into the topic itself. So if you haven't seen that particular video, this is the URL for that, bit.ly/ASP.NET EF Core CRUD. So where I have performed like CRUD operations with the help of ASP.NET Core framework, and we have used the MVC framework there. So let's directly jump into the Visual Studio and run this particular application and see how it works. So here you can see, like, this is a simple CRUD operation app, and I have used the default Bootstrap template provided by ASP.NET Core. So we haven't done nothing new. So basically, like, this is a listing screen. From here I can create my new employee there. From here I can edit that. From here I can see the details of that particular employee, and from here it will ask me to delete this particular employee, and like it will delete the existing employee. So there are a couple of things which I wanted to cover. So let's first go through that, and then we'll go like each and every actions and operations in detail. So here, if you see in this particular, so this is our employee controller there, and it is inherited by controller. So that is, so in this particular video, I wanted to emphasize on the controller and actions, where I wanted to explain you how it works and what is going to be special about the controller and actions. So basically, controller is a special class which acts as middle tier between your data, which is your entities, and views. So a controller is used to define the logical group of actions. So action is a special kind of method which handles the request mapped with the routing. So I have explained that in my previous video, but like we are going to see that stuffs here also. And here you can see like actions methods are mapped with the HTTP verbs. So default HTTP verbs is get, and then other three: pause, put, and delete. And controller class is normally inherited by controller class itself. So here you can see like it is inherited from the controller class. Then there are two limitations of action method. So first limitation is action method, it should be always public, and action method cannot be static. So here you can see there is an employee controller there, which is inherited by controller class. Then we have a couple of action methods. So this is our index action method, then there is a details, then there is a create method. So we have two for create. Why we have two action methods for create, which I am going to explain in detail, so wait for it. Then same thing for edit, like we have two things there, and same thing from the delete confirm method. So here you can see each and every action method is public, right? This is a private method, but it is not an action method. We are just checking here that employee exists or not, right? So now if you go into this particular index method, here what we are doing is we are returning a list of employees to view. So now let's run this application again and see how it works. So here you have seen that it is hitted there. So basically, like as I told you, like action method is mapped with the URL. So here in our browser, you can see employees there, and then it is hitting this particular index. Why it is hitting this particular breakpoint with the index action method? Because in the startup, if you remember in the previous video, I have explained that we have created our controller patterns or routing pattern like this. So there will be a controller name. By default, controller is home, and default action and slash action name, which is our default method. So if you haven't specified any action, it is going to be load index one. So that's why it hitting this particular action methods. So let's continue, and if you see there, it will load our data. Even if you do employee slash index, it will do the same, right? So here you can see like it is hitting your breakpoint and it is loading that particular data. So now if you see here, what we are doing is returning an employee list. And if you go into that particular view, so from here also you can see, click on that and go to view, or it is there in views folder. Okay, so in views, we are seeing that we are having our model, which is bind to this particular view, and basically it is our entity employee. And here we are having this display name, which is like this part, and that part is based on the employee entity which we created. So if you go into this, here you can see like first name is there. So here you can write your different name also, but that we are going to see in the another videos. There are lots of customize that needs to be done, but it is not a part of this particular video, otherwise it will be very broad. Okay, so here what we are doing is we are iterating our model, so which is an enumerable or a list, and then we are displaying all these steps, and then there is a special type of method called tag helper. So this all are the inbuilt tag helpers there, and we are going to see tag helpers in future videos, and you can also create those tag helpers with your customization. So like you can perform all this request handling stuff with this tag helper. So what it will do is, like if you click on the edit, so here you can see like this is the edit one. So what it is doing is, like it is calling our edit action, and it is passing the item ID, which is our employee ID. So here we are iterating this stuff. So here you can see like this is the ID one, right? Then same thing for details and delete. So what it will do, if you click on this edit, it will load. So here you can see like there is a parameter called one, which is our employee ID, and this is the particular edit action. Now if you see same thing in the employee controllers, here you can see like the edit part is there. So there are two things there for edit, right? What it will do is it will expect one parameter, and this is our get method. So as I told you, like action method is mapped with the particular HTTP verbs, right? So what it will do is, it will check first if ID is exist, or like if ID is passed. If not passed, then it will return the not found status, which is 404. Then what it is doing is, like from this employee context, it is finding the employee with that particular ID. So if you hit the breakpoint here, and if you refresh this, here you can see we got the ID 1. right, which is there, same here, right? And then if you run this particular, so here you can see it is fetching all these tabs from the database, and then it is checking that our employee is there in the database. Otherwise, if it is not there, then it will return the not found status, which is our 404. And if it is found, then it is returning this particular view. So now again, if you see, if you click on this and if you see the view, here you can see like it is giving model as an employee. And here we are having again the tag helpers for validations. So what it will do is like it will perform this validation. So if I remove this, if I try to save this, it will fire the validation. Right. Now, if you see in the edits.cshtml, here you can see we have a form actions edit, right? So as I explained you, in the once you click on the edit, like it will load all this data filled with these tabs, and then if you put a save, which is our submit button, so what it will do is like this is a HTML form, so HTML form will create a post action, which is a HTTP post. Wow. So now if you go into the edit part, so this is a, this was our get actions where it is loading all these employees. Now here you can see like there are two implementations of edit action method. So one is for HTTP post. So this is validate and anti forgery token. So it will make sure that like it will be, this request is from this particular site only. Okay. We are going to see all these steps in these security related videos. But for now, let's concentrate on the basic part. So in this particular, here you can see we are having ID. Then we are also passing the our employee class, and then again it is checking, making sure that this employee is having the same ID as the ID passed, and if it is not there, then it will return the found stuff. And if the model is valid, then it will create this update part, right? So here it is using the employee context or our database context update method, and then we'll get all these steps saved in the database, right? And here you can see like we have used try and catch, right? And that try and catch will do the exception handling. We are going to see exception handling in detail in future videos. So for this, like if it is throwing any exceptions, will throw not found or a particular exception. So now once this update operation is performed, at that time a particular data will be saved into the SQL Server table, and then it will redirect to particular action. So again you can say like redirect to action is there. So what it will do is that it will redirect to particular index file. So if I edit this, right, if I remove this one from here and if I save this, so here you can see it is hitting our index one, and it will load the listing part. That is what this particular redirect to action is doing. Now let's go through the create part. So in the create part, there are again two methods there, as I explained you. There is one from create, and here we are returning empty view because right now we don't know anything about our employee stuff, right? So we are going to create a new employee there. So that's why this is blank, and this is the HTTP post version. So if you go into the create view, so same thing is there. Here you can see like this is the HTML form there, and then we have tag helpers for validations, and those validations are considered from the our entity class. So you see here, these are the validations part, right? So if I don't type anything and if I put this, so here you can see it is putting same stuff which I have written with this data annotation. So this telling our tag helpers that first name and last name is required, right? And once you click on this create part, like this create button, it will hit this particular create, and then it will check as per our validations part that like all the validations is fulfilled. And if it is not, then it is going to return this view again and like put this kind of validations there. And if it is good, then we have our add method there and it is saving the changes there. Okay, so I hope this is the clear things there. Okay, now same thing for details. So detail is nothing, just it is retaining the existing employee path, right? So it is retaining the first employee which is we are getting. So there are a couple of entity framework methods which we are going to discuss, but like either you can use find or you can use first of default, and both will do same thing. Okay, then there is a delete part. So if you go to back to this particular list and if you click on delete, what it is doing, it is sending this particular ID which is we are expecting here, and here again the same thing is there, right? So it will check if ID is passed to this particular URL. If not, then it will return the not found stuff, and then it is checking to make sure that the employee or the employee ID which passed for deletion is also existing in the database. So that is what it is doing right now, and then it is returning this particular employee here. And now we have to click on this delete. Okay, so let's go into the view itself. So here you can see like it is, what it is doing is like it is displaying all these steps. Then here if you click on this particular delete part, right, here you can see form action is delete, right? Now if you go into the this particular one, here you can see they have shown other things also. Like basically what it they have done is they are you can put action names also here, where you can map this particular action with this delete action. So what it is doing is it is expecting a ID, then it is finding that particular employee with the find method, and then it is going to win. And once you hit the save changes, it will save all these changes into the database and delete the steps or employee from the database. That's it for this particular video. I hope like now everything is pretty much clear. So thank you for watching this video, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel, then please do subscribe to my channel, because as I told you, like it gives me more motivation to create such videos like this. Okay, so thanks again for watching, and see you in the next video.